El Salvador's government will be deploying at least 800 police officers and troops to their border with Honduras and Guatemala in an effort to push back those migrants that are trying to get U.S. bound. The police will also be backed by another 350 officials from the immigration departments of El Salvador, adding to troops that are already on there from Central American countries, as well as the Mexican border, the southern Mexican border, being stronger than it has been. After meeting with Vice President Mike Pence and a brief exchange with President Trump in Washington on Tuesday, Mexican Foreign Minister said he is expected, further and more significant decreases in the U.S.-bound migration through Mexico. This is a huge, huge thing. You know, it is one of the top three concerns from the American people when surveyed is the border. The difficult thing for Democrats, a wonderful thing for Republicans, is the Democrats don't have a leg to stand on. I don't know what they're going to do. I think every American knows by now that Democrats despise border security. Oh, they're going to frame it in every which way they can. Well, no, we're for securing the borders, but they're going to try to do that. They weren't for securing the borders in any way, shape, or form. I don't know how they're going to run against a president that has done more for our national security, our homeland security, because of what he has done in the borders than any other president. I don't know how they're going to run against that when that is a key issue for Americans. The other key issue is the economy. I don't know how they're going to argue the fact that we have the lowest African-American lowest unemployment rate in the history of this nation going down again, Hispanic unemployment at an all-time record high, meeting where it got to that all-time record high back in February. It is there again. Unemployment among women is at the lowest level it has ever been. Asian unemployment at the lowest level it has ever been. Wages seeing 16-year highs. We are looking at wages possibly increasing by 4% by the end of this year. 7 million more job openings than we have people to fill them. We have slowed down dramatically illegal immigration and border crossings that are going unchecked. We are now seeing those border crossings or those people attempting to claim asylum as going through a legal process if they want to do that, and that has dramatically slowed down the process in general. I don't know what the Dems are going to do, but good luck with trying to run against that, and good luck to try to reframe all the conversations they've said. Hey, I want to thank you for watching the clip. We sure do appreciate it. Would you go right now, click on that subscribe button if you haven't already? That helps us. We would appreciate it. Thanks again.